You know what I mean? That's not just not that. Let's just go see your car. Let me see the money in your pocket, cuz let's go knock off a new fit. You the best rapper in the code. What that do for you? It don't do nothing for you. And I'm telling y'all, bro, you don't want to live in this your life, man. I mean, just look around. Okay. All you got to do is look around, my nigga. Look when I leave. Look while I'm here. Wake up in the morning, jump in your car, and just ride around this city. And see how that motivates you. And say, damn, is this the end? Is this the end? Is this it for me? What make Flip different from me? Slim Thug, all these people getting what? I can do that? And if I'm saying, if I'm looking at TV saying, man, why these niggas? Why, all right, well, do something, nigga. Let me worry about what they doing. Or how, do something and quit crying. See, niggas sitting there whining, hating on niggas. Niggas move and do something. And you're not going to do it right here, okay? I moved to Atlanta 4 times before I got a record deal. You got to move. You got to get around and go. I don't give a fuck where it's at. You got to move, okay? You got the network. MySpace, a major tool. They didn't have that shit when I was doing things. Now they do. You got to utilize that, make connections, holler at niggas, put that music on there. Don't put that bullshit on there, cut it. You got to understand there's 97 million people on here. A percentage of those people are musicians. Mm-hmm. A lot of them are professional musicians. Your shit is on there going against all these people. Why would you put some shit on there that ain't sounding right? The ad-libs over here, this over there. You represent yourself, cut it. Niggas ain't gonna look at that artwork and just think just cause the artwork hot, the song's hot, niggas ain't finna give you them type of props. You gotta put that heat on there. You got 400 listens to a song that's subpar. So niggas like, shit, nigga, all right. You more than all right, but you giving them all right, so you perceive it as all right. But if you go in there, you make sure your shit lined up right, nigga, I want it mixed right. I don't want this over here when I hear it. Let's clean it up now. Put it on there, record it, put that good music on there, like the tracks you be making, the hooks you niggas come up with. Hey man, you have to learn how to make the songs, man. Arrange them, everything. It's a whole nother form of doing this shit when they're paying you $7 million a year. It's a whole nother thing, cut it. You gotta write that shit where it works. It ain't all about just writing about what you do, it's about big records. You know they just dropped Christina Milian, bro. They just dropped Jewel Santana from Def Jam. You saw this nigga on TV every day. Seen 2 or 3 videos. He ain't sell no records. He paid him. You understand? Christina Milian ain't sell no records. So they don't mean, cut it, just because you famous, it don't mean you gonna sell records. It can't be about you. It gotta be about, man, let me write this. Push yourself out there. You know what's hot? What make you dance?
The square.
What make, what get in your bones? You know what I mean? What song have you saw the girls dance to? And every time you see them dance to that song, it make them do the damn fool. I need a song like that. I don't need that style of that song, but I need a song that do that. You know what I mean? When have you been driving a song like a road song, get in you and make you cry, make you reflect? I need a song like that. You know what I mean? Not about for me, but for the people. I want to feel like the music make me feel. So if music make you feel one way, but you giving people something else, man, you giving us something artificial. All my songs real, bro. You hear them? I'm going to talk about me. That's all I can talk about. I mean, I got shit now, so you mention shit. But you don't hear no capping. But it's all about being real, man. If you be real to yourself, you be real to God, because the sky's the limit. And you got to get out of this city, man, because other than that, my nigga is not going to work. Now, a nigga like me, I'm going to come back and do this. When my situation pop off, cutting, it's like when Jesus said, hey, let those who have ears hear and let those who have eyes see. So, at that point, it's all on you. It's really all on everybody else. And Raheem will tell you, man, I called Raheem from Hollywood, didn't I? Didn't I try to fly you up there?
Yeah.
Before any Raheem come telling you, before the album's halfway done, Raheem wouldn't listen to me. Ask Crenshaw what I told him, why he been up there over a year. Crenshaw, cut this, you got 1 week. You ain't up here in a week, cut it, I'm changing my number, I'm not talking to you no more. Shit, Crenshaw was up there in 3 days. And the label paid for his flight. But look what Crenshaw been doing since he been there. Doing the damn fool. But I had to beg him to leave. But now you can't beg him to come back. So you gotta go out of to see what you missing, cut it, in order to know, cut it, this ain't where the world ended. It don't, cut it. It's bigger than this. Be around that money. See these phantoms. See these niggas walking up with just all this stuff around you every day. You surround them. My boss live in a $4 million house. He got ostrich ceilings. Cut it. We be over there every day just in this bitch. He'd be like, yeah, you're going to move right there. And dead serious. Like, that's you're going to be my neighbor as soon as this record drops. Because money mingle with money. Because I know so many millionaires and plastic, so I ain't got no millions. But money mingle with money, and seeing that motivate me. Seeing that say, God damn, that's what we missing? Going out to eat every day where they valet your cars and everybody got money, ain't nobody ever broke. That's what I've been missing. In the hood, nickel and diamond, selling little nickel dimes, bags of weed, taking penitentiary chances for crumbs, flipping 50 sacks for crumbs, when they gonna give me 50 years for 5 rocks? This what I wanna do. Just to go to the club and pay $5, $10 for a ticket and I'm fly for a day, got out and went Reggie's and got a fit. That's what I wanna do for the rest of my life. Go in a makeshift studio and out rap niggas in the hood, that's what I wanna do. Or do I wanna get this money? Do I want shoe deals, rim deals, real estate? Do I want that or do I want this? So at the end of the day, this is what you gotta do, man. You gotta believe in God, Cuddy. And if you pray to God and this is your purpose and your destiny, he gonna give it to you. Just like he gave it to me. And I'm not different from nobody out here, bro. I went to prison for 8 years for attempted murder, Cuddy. I thought that was the end for me. I got out of that when I thought I was never coming back, and I'm back here. And for 6 years, I stayed real and grind. Now look where I'm at. And doing that, I never stepped on nobody's toes or shit on nobody. But I was in quicksand, sinking, and still tried to pull niggas up. And now I'm back, cutting my feet halfway on land, and I'm still saying, hey, come on. So now niggas got to start moving theyself. You can't be over me, cutting.